Hello everyone, name's Ian. I've been meaning to do a bunch of these Rhino postings because a few of my classmates are interested in the program, and I'm not very good with tutoring. I can basically show you what I know how to do, and as far as learning the program, it's basically up to you as far as playing around with it. But I figured I can broadcast some of my work while I do it and kind of give you guys an idea how the thing runs. So besides that, there's really no other format except I guess you can watch me model. And this is my Pandora. Let's see, where am I? Making windows. Wait a minute. Yep, a lot of clicking lines. Should have had this grouped already. There we go. So as you see here, I got four elevations boxed around. It's kind of hard to see, but I got a floor plan laid out here. And all my AutoCAD drawings. So I got my four elevations, I got my framing plans, the roof plans, two sections, floor plan layout. This kind of gives me all my dimensions. This is actually what I use to scale everything from. We DIST, that's distance. From there to there, that should be 8 feet. Yep. See right there, 8 feet exact. So now we're dealing with full scale modeling right here. So, yeah. What the hell am I missing? No. There we go. I like to keep my model being the only thing in my window, just the space that I'm working on. Keeps your machine from lagging. Now I know I could just explode this, or ungroup this segment right here, and just cap that off and then extrude it, but I prefer to have my, excuse me, my poly surfaces. I like to have them separate from my floor plans, just, you know, create a new object there. This button that it keeps going to, the yellow magnifying glass, is zoom to selected. This is, you know, zoom extends. What I like about these two buttons is that you get out of there. Yeah. So you zoom your extended, shoots it right there. But if you zoom out again, if you right click, shoots it into all four windows. Same with right-clicking the zoom extent. So if you just need a real fast way of looking at all your information, that's a good way of doing it. But again, like how I simplified my drawing space by hiding everything that was over here. I don't know if you see my mouse, but I'm pointing towards the arrows. By hiding everything there, then I can freely use this and, you know, focus solely on my model. If I have anything else showing, even the tiniest little line or node, it'll incorporate that, obviously, because it's, you know, zoom extent. So, you know, I just want to be careful about that. Doesn't make too much of a difference. It's just kind of annoying sometimes. And I had been raising each one of these things, as you noticed before, individually. You know, highlight, extrude, highlight, extrude, highlight, extrude. But, you know, there's nothing really stopping me from highlighting all of them, hitting extrude and bringing it to where it's supposed to be. I just like to sometimes, you know, double check myself, because, you know, do it right the first time, you know? See, like this one, I'm missing a line on there, so if I were just shoot through it and not pay attention, I'd be sorry. Oh, I'm missing two lines. You gotta say, I really love the ease in modeling in this program. It's very intuitive once you get used to it. So that's basically what I have so far in progress that I've made. This old roof garden here, still not quite to yet. Another tactic I like to do is try to simplify this. Put my section directly through my model where it needs to be, so I can, you know, double check that everything's accurate and everything's up to the right height and lined up and all that. So let's see. And my section cuts. Ah, there they are. There's one. There's the other. Yeah, those are my two section cuts. So. This one on there. I'm going to try to keep my references as a group because, actually, I'll show you if you ungroup that right now. You want to. Everything is completely separated. See?
I haven't tried that. Thank you.
shouldn't cut corners. You really shouldn't cut corners. Not worth it. Now, Revit likes to do this whole I'm going to be a single plane surface thing, and that's just not going to cut it for me. So that. I don't feel like I'm cutting corners. Oh yeah, that's this is why you never want to use yellow in AutoCAD if you're going to be using Rhino, because this is the color that shows up, and when you highlight it, it doesn't look like anything. It's very, very annoying. Let's see what we got here. Thank you.
Thank you. best rated Android phone just got better with the HTC One X Plus. Enjoy more speed, more storage, and more battery life. Everything you want in a phone plus more. HTC One X Plus.
I'm sorry. Thank you. is it that I feel so cut up and so bad? I need to take control. My mind is on the go. It is on your side.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I think that's about all I can handle for right now. Getting sleep. Getting tired of looking at the screen. I think I'm gonna get myself some exercise, some fresh air, some blood in my legs. It's a good thing. Say that missing my ground cover layer. I haven't gotten there yet. So I need to bully in that one. So I get this nice crisp line like that. Still got work to do. Many miles before I sleep. Well, thank you for watching, and I guess subscribe or circle me or like me on Twitter or whatever you'd like. Spatial Pioneer. Later.